mobile number. What's the mobile number? Is it 075 64 30 30 64? 075 64 30 30 64. That is the mobile number. Look, I've done that without the aid of any visual things, if you know what I mean. So, as I say, lots of things have happened and things have been going on. I was spun round by, you know, in Matilda, when Miss Trunchbull spins the little girl round by her pigtails. That's what I was like on these roller skates this afternoon. And when they stopped, I'd actually felt quite peculiarly sick. I really did. Now, they were lovely girls. And I've got to thank a lady called Nicola, who looked after my handbag while I had a twirl, and she filmed me. So, Nicola, I know you said you didn't live round here. You lived, I think you said, was it Sheffield? Somewhere like that. But you can still get us, because other countries in the world can get us. You just have to go on and go on to www.solialradio.com, and we will be there for your delectation and delight. And you can listen to us. Right, I am having a thought. I've got a guest on the 8th of September. Don't get excited. His name's Danny Stone. He's a really nice guy. Ah, me and Danny got on really well. Can you believe there's a male version of me?
I don't know whether that's a good thing or not.
But anyway, I thought new studio, new ideas. Are you braced for this, Nick? Right, okay, so my new idea. I'm going to have a problem phoning. Oh, shall I turn you on? I shouldn't have said that. I'm going to put Nick, necktie Nick's here.
What's that, sorry?
I said I'm going to have a problem. I'm thinking of having a problem page.
Oh, right, okay. You're going to be like an agony aunt.
Yes.
Debs.
So do you think? I think I'd be quite good at that, don't you?
I think you'd be fantastic.
Yeah, because I like to. I'm really into me empowerment and me. And, you know, positiveness.
Okay.
I don't do well with negative people. If negative people come into my life, I'm afraid they come in the door, knock it, and then go back out.
So you don't like mood hoovers?
Oh, no. Oh, we had a couple of them, haven't we? We've had a couple of them.
Yeah, I've come across a few of those. Yeah, or energy vampires. That's another thing.
Oh, I like these
two. That's a good phrase.
Energy vampire. Oh, that sounds quite... Yes. Yeah. Yes, I'd like to. Anyway, so I've decided I'm going to try and have it. So if you've got anything... Now, look, I'm not an expert. I can only give you advice from my 55 years of living. And I actually gave advice to somebody last night. One of my, gay friends came round, and he has his eye on a gentleman that he quite likes, who is gay as well. So that's fine. But this guy that he's got his eyes on is sort of doing that, you know, that player thing.
Is he playing the field?
He's playing the field and he's keeping my friend dangling like a cat with a mouse.
That's not fair.
No, it's not fair. And the way I look at relationships is that, okay, you're going to have your little ups and downs and your little bumps in the road, but there should be no questions about anything. Do you know what I mean? You should have doubt about
no doubt or uncertainty.
Yes. And if you've got doubt and uncertainty... To me, it's not right. It's not right for you. But, because he said, well, I really like him. I said, but he's not the only gay man in the world. It's not like you and him are the only two gay men in the world. You know, there are lots of gay men who are very, very nice. I met one the other day who was a lovely man. You know, and I just thought to myself, I said to him, you can't... Just put all your eggs in one basket with one relationship. And, you know, I said to him, you're only young and you've got a lot of life to live yet.
What a positive message that you're giving out.
Well, I do my best.
So what are people going to do? Are they going to ring you?
Well, I'd like them to either ring me or they can text me or they can email. And if it's a night when, you know, I'm not here, you can all get the emails to me and the texts and that, can't I? So I've got time to think about it. And I'm still going to have my thought of the week or the day, because I like to do that, because I think that sort of boosts you a little bit. And I was going to do something about a pause for thought. Now, I did think about getting some members of the church in, so like a vicar, an imam, a rabbi, you know, various religions. I did think about that. And then I thought, What about the pause for thought came from my listeners? What if they're positive affirmations? They came in. Like, I give them a positive thought every week. Why don't they give me their positive thoughts that I can put out on air? And they can ring the show and they can be on air and say what they're feeling.
Have you got one that you've had in mind that you've come up with?
I've got my thought of the day for today. I do a different one each week. But wow. I don't do...
That's still to come.
Yeah, that's still. I don't do it till about 7 o'clock.
Okay.
Because it's about to be 18-18 on the 18th of the 8th, 18.
What are we doing for that then?
We're going to put the adverts on.
Wow. Well, we know how to party at Solihull Radio, don't we, Debs?
Oh, we do. I love it. I love. Do you know what I'm more excited about? Is the fact that they've given me a mouse with no wire on it. So it goes round the table like a proper mouse.
You do know, I bought that.
Nick bought that?
I did.
Necktie Nick.
I eyed that up.
I haven't told you why I call you Necktie Nick, have I?
Why?
You're more casual lately. Actually, since he's had that makeover, folks. Since he's had that makeover, Andy, I hope she doesn't mind me mentioning, and he has a new lady in his life. He's got a new lady in his life.
Do I?
Lucky him. I don't want a lady in my life. I want a man in my life.
Do you?
Yeah. I didn't get one for my birthday. I don't know when he's going to land.
We had a pact, didn't we?
We had a pact, me and Nick, that in 10 years' time, if he hadn't met somebody and I hadn't met somebody, we were going to get married. But unfortunately, I think I've been unceremoniously dumped by Mr. Whitehouse.
Sorry, Debs.
It's all right. But she's... I don't want to say too much because she's listening, but she's a lovely girl and she's very pretty.
She is very pretty, yeah.
Yeah, she is. So you've done well there. You've done well there, Annie.
I did. I'm boxing above my weight there, aren't I?
No, you're not. You're not. I've got to say, I had to smile on Wednesday because I went out with this guy, Danny, who's gay.
Yeah.
And he's lovely. Really, really attractive man, actually. I thought, oh, why are you gay? That's what I thought.
That's just life, isn't it?
Anyway, and then this little Romanian lady came in with her bowl of rope and she was saying, what a nice looking couple we were. Well, I said, I couldn't say, could I, anything. So we just stood there smiling at her, bless her.
Do you know what's interesting? Just a little aside. I'm sure my lovely lady won't mind me mentioning. I'm buying a new kitchen. At the moment.
Good lad.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. But it's amazing how we just go and have a little look at these kitchens. And it's my house, my money. But everybody talks to her about the kitchen that I might be interested in having. And I'm there going, it's my kitchen.
It's because there's a stereotype going on there then, isn't there?
Yeah, there is. There is. And also, we obviously look like a good couple then.
You do?
Because we're probably arguing in the back of B&Q or something like that.
We don't want to know what you do in the back of B&Q.
Well, yeah, around the lighting section.
Yes, around the lighting section. How terrible. Absolutely. Not
in the plumbing section.
Right, no, not in the plumbing.
All right.
No, nor the fencing. We don't do fencing. Right, I'm going to go for an ad. Here we go. Oops-a-daisy.
Every morning and hate that yucky mould patch in the bathroom. It's time to contact EnviroVent. They've helped tackle mould and condensation dampness in over a million homes, just like yours. To find out more and to book a free home survey, visit EnviroVent.com because air matters.
Solihullradio.com.
Stagecoach Solihull teaches skills
in drama, singing and dance.
But these skills don't just vanish when the curtain falls.
They're skills for life, stretching imaginations and improving literacy. For a career in the arts, learning new skills, or just having fun.
So visit our website,
www.stagecoach.co.uk/Solihull.
Stagecoach Solihull, skills for the arts.
Skills for life.
Yeah!
The Fireplace and Stove Centre, 1204 Stratford Road, Hall Green. Specialists in wood-burning stoves, gas and electric fires with over 50 live displays in the showroom. Come in and experience your new fireplace solutions. Call 0121 777 8585 for more details.
You're listening to Solihull Radio.
Indian Indian Dream on Dove House Parade, Sully Hall's premier family-run restaurant offering authentic Indian and Bangladeshi cuisine with fresh ingredients and creative chefs. They can provide bespoke dining experiences, eat in or take away. 0121 704 9058.
Right. You know, the other week when I said I was going to take Evie O'Brien to see the police dogs, we went. Oh my golly gosh, what gorgeous little puppies they were. Oh, absolutely. And she was in her element. And I think her mummy has put some photos on Facebook for you to see her. But absolutely lovely. And I've got to say, I did want to come home with the dog at that point. But I thought, oh, I can't. It wouldn't be fair. It wouldn't be fair to that little dog. So, because I'm at work. But I've been off for 6 weeks. Because you know what I do for a job. I've been off for six. We've got 2 weeks left, I think. But I've never been so busy. You know, when you normally, everybody goes, oh, I'm bored now, I've had enough of this time off. Well, I haven't, because I haven't got, and I really, seriously, don't know how I'm going to get back to work and do my job and do the radio, because I'm very pulled towards the radio, to be honest, and I'm wondering what's going to happen. I think I'm going to have to somehow work it in that I actually, I don't know. Oh, it'll work out. Life always works out. It don't matter what it throws at you. Life always works out. It's the way it is. I'm going to put a track on now because I need to speak to Necktie Nick because we may have a problem. I might have to get my camp bed out. That's all I'm saying. All right. I'm going to put a bit of Jennifer Hudson on for you because I like Jennifer Hudson. Right, here we go. And she's going to be standing under your spotlight.
Busted out. Is that you? Is that you? Oh, baby.
right. That was, you know, what's happening at the moment, and I'm not going to lie to you, because I can't, is we have got, when we first started at Solihull Radio, when we were in our old studio, we had a lot of, you know, a lot of little techie issues that you get. It's all right, I'm doing my training because my foot's hurting. And we had to work them all out. And as it is, like, you know, when you move into a new house and whatever and something doesn't work and this works and that was, we're all sort of in trying to find everything out and what's happening and why and how and whatever. So I think we're doing okay. I think we're doing fine. And I've got to say that the few shows I've listened to this week, that the sound is much clearer and I'm so much more happy about that. Anyway, getting back to the puppies that we went to see, I did have to frisk Miss O'Brien as she left just to make sure she hadn't put a puppy in her pocket. Do you know what I mean? So I had to do that. But I'd like to say thank you to Greg. See me. So I want to say thank you to Greg for looking after me. And Dave Raymond, I have sent you a text to say, can you come on my show and talk about dog handling and puppy walking? Because West Midlands Police would like volunteers who can... Now, don't be volunteering if you work or, you know, you've got this going on or that going on, because there's no point, is there? Because you're not there for a little dog, are you? That's the thing. You're not there. So what you need to do is, if you're interested in puppy walking for West Midlands Police, now don't get too attached to them either, because they are working dogs and they are there to do a job. But I've got to say, I did get attached to one and I didn't realise it was Greg's dog, Bramble and Amy's, and she's lovely. And she was looking up through that and I thought, oh, I could take you home. And then he went, that's my dog. And I went, oh, okay. Well, maybe I won't then. But she's a Springer Spaniel and she's absolutely gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Anyway, then, as if I hadn't given Greg enough grief, I then popped along to see him at the air training corps at Chelmsley Wood in the week, which was very nice. And they looked after me as well. They did me a cup of tea. Thank you very much, which I quite enjoyed. Oh, thank you. So I've had quite a busy holiday. Jess has been away for the week in Devon. She's coming back tomorrow. So I'm going to pop in tomorrow with Lee to just make sure that, not that I know what I'm doing very much at the moment, but I will get there. I always get there. See, I'm one of these people who doesn't... I don't do very well with change, but once I've got there, I'm all right. And I've just read a book called Who's Moved My Cheese? And it basically, you need to read it, because it helps you to adjust to change, which a lot of us don't do very well. There's quite a few of us don't adjust well to change, and we need to start thinking about it. Anyway, on the 21st of August, Pete the T-Rex is at Earlswood Lakes. Don't ask, I don't know how big he is. But because they're having a craft, that's so hard to say when you haven't got your teeth in, a craft centre fun day. That's what they're doing. And it's on between 11 and 3. And you can take you can go along or your children or whatever and go to Earlswood Lakes and have a bit of fun with your crafts. That's what I'm going to say. Enjoy yourself. Talking about crafts, I've got to make a cushion cover. And I've got to, what else have I got? Oh, and I've got to make something. Oh, a pump bag for my little grandson. Oh, so looking forward to doing that. I like making pump. I like making things for my grandsons. Anyway, you can call me on 0121 704 0185. I'm sure there's a slicker way I can say that. Or text me on 075 6430 3064. Oh, I've remembered. Or you can text on studio@solihullradio.com and I will speak unto you. If you're interested in me doing a problem page, please get in touch, because I'd love to know how many people would like me to do it. If you have any positive things going on in your life that you'd like everybody else to know about, please get in touch and I'll put you on air. Well, you don't have to go on air. You can tell me about it and then I will help you out. help you out. That's it. No. You can tell me about it. And if you want me to, I will tell people out there that are listening. That's what I meant to say. It's ever since they spun me around on them roller skates. Now, I went there this afternoon because we were under the impression that there was going to be a hula hooping as well, because I love it. You know what I'm like? I love my hula hoop. I haven't done it for a while now. I need to get myself into it again. I really do. What was I going to say? And I was looking forward to the hula hooping, but it wasn't there. But there was two lovely girls on roller skates. And as I say, if you go onto our Facebook page or our Twitter feed or our Instagram, you'll see me being twirled around and the noise I made. Oh, but I got, they put me on the floor and I thought, I did feel rather ill. I thought I'd gone a very peculiar colour. But they did take me around at speed. They did take me around at speed. Right, now listen, I'm going to give you a bit of this. No, I'm not. I'm going to give you a bit of this.
Solihullradio.com.
There you go. And then what I'm going to do, well, I don't know what's going on here. I'm going to stop that because I don't want that. And I'm going to start that. And I'm not going to play you another track. I'm all out the window today. I've decided that I am going to be a lot more professional. I think I am. I think I'm quite professional anyway. People seem to enjoy listening to me, so I'm glad about that. So thank you very much. All those that do listen to me, thank you very much. We have got... Oh. Hold on a minute. It's all right. I'm just reading something, making sure that I haven't missed anything, because you do slightly worry. Right. So it's a big thing now, getting into our new studio. And do you know what I like? I actually feel quite safe being here on my own, because if you can get into me right now, you're either Spider-Man or, you know, you've got an angle grinder, whatever it is, because it's like Fort Knox up here, and I feel quite safe. It's funny because our other studio, as I say, was like smaller, and this one's, but it is lovely. I've got to say, it is really lovely, and it feels just lovely and professional and great and whatever. Right, now, while I was being spun round at 99 miles an hour this afternoon, I actually picked up a leaflet from the Core Theatre in Solihull. So I can tell you all the things that are going on at some point. Which is great, because I was getting slightly worried that I wasn't giving enough information, because you know I love the theatre, I do. Right, we have Bank Holiday Weekend next weekend, and there's lots of things going on in Solihull for that, and there's theatre news, and I have my thought of the day. What else have I got? Whew. I've got things that are going on at Hall Green Little Theatre, and a pause for thought. Now, if you know somebody who is a vicar or an imam or a rabbi or a priest or a Sikh leader of the church, a guru, and you think that they would give a positive pause for thought on my show, would you please get in touch? And I'll take, if they don't mind, I'll take their number and I'll give them a call and see if they come on. They haven't got to come on every week. What they can do is actually ring in if needs be. But, you know, it's if people want to do it. I don't want people to feel pressurised into doing it. That's what I don't want. Now, the air training corps at Chelmsley Wood. I went over there and my friend Greg is their commanding officer. So there you go, military again. I obviously look like a woman who needs a bit of discipline, but there you go. And he was saying that if anybody's interested, to get in touch, and they can pop over and have a look and see what they think. So if you think you would like to join the air train... Now, when I say the air training corps, it doesn't mean you're going to go there, they're going to put a uniform on you and you're going to fly a fighter jet around the... No. But he was telling me the things they do. They do parades. You can go when you've been there a while, but you can go and do shooting. I said, what do you mean real bullets? And they said, well, we start off with like little pellets and then build up. And I thought, oh my gosh. What else can you do? You can go on a flying weekend. You can go camping. So you're under canvas. It sounds actually, I've got a feeling, I seem to vaguely remember my brother being in that when he was younger, and he loved every second of it. You can even go abroad with them. And, you know, if you're at a bit of a lost end and you don't know what sort of thing to do, or you feel like you want to do something but you don't know what you want to do, then please get in touch with these guys. You might go along and you might not like it, but you don't know until you try, can you? Do you? You really don't know until you try. So I think what you need to do is spread those wings and excite yourself. That's what you need to do. Right, I am going to play this, a bit of Sam Smith, because I like Sam Smith's voice.
You must think that I'm stupid. You must think that I'm a fool. You must think that I'm new to this. But I have seen this song before. I'm never gonna let you close to me, even though you mean the most to me. Cause every time I open up it hurts. So I'm never gonna get too close to you, even when I mean the most to you. In case you go and leave me in the dirt. But every time you hurt me, the less that I cry. And every time you leave me, the quicker these tears dry. And every time you, I love you, baby, we don't stand a chance. It's sad but it's true. I'm way too good at goodbye.
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 I know you're thinking I'm heartless. I know you're thinking I'm cold. I'm just protecting my innocence. I'm just protecting my soul. I'm never gonna let you close to me, even though you mean the most to me. Cause every time I open up it hurts. So I'm never gonna get too close to you, even when I mean the most to you. In case you go and leave me in the dirt. But every time you hurt me, the less that I cry. And every time you leave me, the quicker these tears dry. And every time you walk out, the less I love you. Baby, we don't stand a chance. It's sad but it's true. I'm way too good at goodbye. It's sad but it's true. I'm way too good at goodbye.
He's got the most wonderful voice, don't you think? Oh, I think he's absolutely. Oh, I love. I've got both his CDs, and I just love listening to him. He's got a voice like butter, that lad. He has. Oh, Right, now I've told you about what's happening. Now, the Black Country Night Out is on at the Core Theatre on Thursday, the 25th of October. And it's a Black Country Night of comedy and music, which I thought sounded quite interesting. But there's a little bit of a problem going on in the fact that when I go to the Black Country, I know I've got quite a Birmingham accent, but when I go to the Black Country, I can't hear what they're saying. I don't understand what they're saying. And if I don't understand what they're saying, and I'm not from the Black Country. Somebody asked me that once. Are you from the... No, I'm not. Excuse me. I don't mind. Right. But I don't know what they're talking about. And I actually went on a tour of the Black Country once, and they kept asking me questions. I didn't know what they were saying. And so if a Brummie can't understand a Black Country person, you need to... I think once you're tuned in, you're there. Once you're tuned in. There were so many things I was going to tell you about this week, and I got myself all flustered at the beginning, and I've lost it all now. But you know what? I'm going to plough on. I'm going to plough on like I always do. Right, okay. Oh, gosh. There's some things on at the Core Theatre I will tell you about. And there's still that every third Thursday in the month you can go along to Homer Road and to the Boston Tea Party and have a cup of tea. You can certainly do that. Right. Now, I am going to do my best to describe to you our new studio. For those of you who haven't seen it, I'm going to do my best to describe it to you. You come in the door. Now, you can't just come in the door. You have to go past a security guard and everything. So it's real, you know, it's like Wogan House on Radio 2. It's very, very... Then you come into this reception area where our photographs, hopefully, are going to be on the wall. And then you come into this vast room with lots of pillars. But when I say pillars, I don't mean like pillars that you lie on the bed. Not them sort of pillars, like concrete pillars. And then we have this big room, and we are actually going to try. And so if you know somebody who is getting rid of office furniture or any sort of furniture, now I'm not talking like Chesterfields or anything. Oh, actually, Chesterfield look nice in that corner. But either way, can you get in touch with us and let us know, and we'll either say yes or no. And we're not being rude if we say no. It's just that it's not what we've got in mind, if you know what I mean. So please don't feel that we are going to say no. If you can help us out, we'd love it. We'd love you to help us out. That would be absolutely fantastic. Now, what else has happened this week? Took the present to the fire station. I took the tea bags and the sugar and that to the fire station. Oh, and they said thank you very much. And it was a pleasure. It was a pleasure, absolutely. You've been so good to us. You've helped us out so much. And it was our way of saying thank you. So that's what we've done. We took them a little wee gift, a wee gift. Right, my future guests. I have somebody called Danny Stone coming on my show. And he is, not only has he got his own company that deals with fire safety and, you know, like how to... where you should have your fire extinguishers and stuff, but he is also a kung fu teacher. So I thought it would be a nice idea to have him on, for him to be able to talk about, you know, his life and what's gone on and how he's become gone from having how he got his own business. And then I'm going to see a friend of his on Wednesday, who is actually... It's a bit of he worked for somebody, it didn't work out, and he's now got quite a successful business in the jewellery quarter. So I thought that'd be quite interesting for him to come on the show. I've got Dave Raymond hopefully coming on, and he's a dog handler for the West Midlands Police. And I have hopefully got a firefighter coming on to talk to you about looking after yourself in your own home. So that's what is going to be happening in the next few weeks. Now, you might think that booking a guest on a radio show is, oh, you give them a date and they're there. It's not about that. It's a bit like you have to find a date that's mutual for both of you. So I've got Danny coming on the 8th of September. As I say, I'm going to see Ricky on the Wednesday, so I'm going to see what days he can fit me in. And meanwhile, it'll just be lovely to just get used to the new studio. Actually, I feel like I've got used to it already. I feel like I'm actually sat here talking to you and I don't feel any different. I think I got myself a little bit worked up about it. We have got a few new, like, techie systems for me to get used to, but I do take a while to get used to things. But once I'm there, I'm happy bunny. I will be there. And I've had... Nick's gone now. He's left me. He's abandoned me. He's gone off with his little lady. They're going to have something to eat. And a romantic evening together. How lovely. Right, I am going to play you... Oh. Should I play you this? I'm going to play you Liam Payne and Rita Ora, and it's a song from the 50 Shades Freed film. You know the trilogy, 50 Shades of Grey? Well, this is the last film. I don't think there's another one after this. I've got to say that I read the first book, and I got halfway through the second book, and I got bored. So, no disrespect if you wrote it and you're listening in, but... Anyway, here's the soundtrack for that film. Let's see if we can get it on. Is it going?
Waiting for a lifetime for you.
bit of 50 Shades Freed, as they say. Now, I haven't seen you for 2 weeks. I'm trying to think what I've done over those 2 weeks. I'm trying to think where I've been and what I've done. I had my birthday. Came into Solly Hall. I did. And I bought myself, my mum and my daughter gave me some money, so I bought myself a new watch, which I'm really pleased with. And I had enough money to buy myself 2 pairs of shoes. Now, anybody who knows me knows that I like my shoes. But I quite like my brogy-type shoes, and I tend to wear them with, not a short skirt, but a, you know, a fashionable skirt. And I quite like them. But I found some this week that I absolutely love. So, now I've broken the back of this, shall I say, new studio. Well, I say broken the back. I haven't actually broken the back, but now I've got into it, I'll be all right now. I know I'll be fine. I was just a bit, Because we're getting big now. We're big people now. We're working hard for you. So what we need you to do is let us know if there's anything you want us to let everybody know about. Have you got any charity events going on? Is there anything going on in Solly Hall and surrounding areas that we should be putting out there and letting everybody know about? Is there anything going on in your local rugby club, whatever? Just let us know and we can put it out there and we can let everybody know. And the more people know, the more people will come and support it, won't they? In theory. But if you don't tell us, we don't know. So, you know, how can we help you out? This is the question. Right. Now, I have had, as I was saying to Nick earlier, I've had a couple of ideas for my show. And I'd like your help. Because now I'm thinking, and now we've moved. Brand new slate. That's what we're going to do. And I want your help. If you have got something that is worrying you, you know, nothing legal or anything, because I'm not, that's Jeff's guest department, the legal stuff. But something, you know, that you think you need a neutral opinion on, please get in touch and let me know and I'll do my best to help you. Oh, I must tell you what we're all wearing right now. Anyway, you can call me on 012-1704-0185. You can text me on 075-6430-3064. Or you can email us on thestudio@solihullradio.com. If you'd like a request, please let me know. I'm not promising I can fulfil it, but I will do my best. I'm getting used to the new... we've got a couple of new screens. But to be honest, they're not new screens. They actually are not new screens. What they are is it's just that we've done some things a little bit different. And, you know, if you don't do things different, how are you going to live life on the edge? That's what I say. I'm going to play you some ads and then we're going to go into positive thought mode.
Fed up with condensation every morning and hate that yucky mold patch in the bathroom? It's time to contact EnviroVent. They've helped tackle mold and condensation dampness in over 1 million homes, just like yours. To find out more and to book a free home survey, visit EnviroVent.com, because air matters.
Solihullradio.com.
Stagecoach Solihull teaches skills
in drama, singing and dance.
But these skills don't just vanish when the curtain falls.
They're skills for life, stretching imaginations and improving literacy. For a career in the arts, learning new skills, or just having fun.
So visit our website,
www.stagecoach.co.uk/Solihull.
Stagecoach Solihull, skills for the arts.
Skills for life.
Yeah!
The Fireplace and Stove Centre, 1204 Stratford Road, Hall Green. Specialists in wood-burning stoves, gas and electric fires, with over 50 live displays in the showroom. Come in and experience your new fireplace solutions. Call 0121 777 8585 for more details.
You're listening to Solihull Radio.
Indian Dream on Dubhouse Parade, Solihull's premier family-run restaurant offering authentic Indian and Bangladeshi cuisine with fresh ingredients and creative chefs. They can provide bespoke dining experiences, eat in or take away. 0121 704 9058.
Okay, here we go. This is my positive thought. Well, whether it's a positive thought or what, I don't know. But occasionally, I have the urge to post on Facebook a thought or a positive affirmation. And due to the fact that I live on my own, I like to think that I can share with people who know me what I've been through and, you know, hopefully help other people who have been, you know, are in the situation that I've been in. That's why I do it. I don't do it for self-praise or anything. But this week, I was the recipient of negative dismissive comments from one person. So, my thought of the day. I'm not in the wrong. I've had to write this down because I really had so much to say to you and I didn't want to. I'm not in the wrong for wanting to move forward in my life. Well, you all know that I lost my husband to cancer a few years ago, and I do feel that I'm ready to move forward with my life now. And I am actually refusing to live in a world of grief and darkness and, you know, perpetual mourning, because he wouldn't want that. I'm not going to be doing what Queen Victoria did and mourn for 40 years, because it's not happening. Not in my world, it's not. I've been loved, and I'm sure that I will be loved again. And it will not be because I have, it won't be because I have forgotten what went on in my life, but because I have a great big heart that enjoys people of all makes and models. I like people. I like to meet people. I like to meet different people, and that is important to me, that you get out, because you just stick with the same sort of person. How are you going to enjoy life? How are you going to see the beauty of stuff around you? You're not, are you? That's the thing. And, you know, I like to experience what life throws at me. I like to do something different, like be whirled around like I was today on a pair of roller skates. Absolutely. As much as it made me feel sick, I did enjoy it. It was, you know, it's something I wouldn't have done. And this radio show allows me to do that. But, you know, if you are what I call a negative Nelly or a mood hoover, or what was the other one, that something vampire that Nick said, you know, look around you. There's a lot of beauty around you, and you know, you have to believe that things happen for a reason. And whether they're the worst thing that could happen, like me, somebody dying or whatever, at the end of the day, when that happens, your world ends. Yes, it does. But I'll tell you what else happens, is that a new world opens up for you. And positive things start to happen, and things that you didn't think would happen, happen. I mean, look at me. Wouldn't ever have thought I would be doing this 3 years ago. And I am. And, you know, you can't go round living in the past. You can't. Otherwise, you're going to become very, very sad and down, I suppose, is the word I'm looking for. So, I don't need to justify what I do. I don't need to justify any thoughts that I have or any experiences. And, yeah, you know, I was criticised because I said I felt stronger, the strongest I've ever been. I do feel the strongest I've ever been. I feel like I'm the sort of person now that I've wanted to be for a long time. And, you know, if you feel that that is wrong, then, you know, feel that it's wrong. But you're not going to stop me doing it, so you might as well put up with it. Or just put up or shut up. That's basically what I'm saying to you. If you don't like it, don't say it. As Bambi used to say, if you can't say nothing nice, don't say nothing at all. So I am going to play. Now, I'm going to play this song. My lovely friend, Liz, and I love her to bits. Bless her. The unfortunate thing happened that happened to me, and she lost her husband a couple of weeks ago. And he was a lovely man. But what is hurting me is that I know what she's got to go through to get where I am. And I'm struggling with it. But this song is for you, Liz, because you've always been the strength that I needed. And now I'm going to be the strength that you need. But I'm going to play you this song because this is for you. And it's what I feel about you. So hopefully...
Never have sunlight on your face.
go. I love that song. And, you know, Lisa has been a tower of strength for me in the past. And I'd like to think that I'm going to be a tower of strength for her. So I love you to bits, mate. Please take care of yourself. And I shall see you Monday night. And I shall make your life sheer and utter misery by being present in it. There you go. Anyway, we've got a competition on Solihull Radio and you can take part. You go onto our Facebook feed and you can put a comment or a name or whatever you want to write within reason, and please let it be polite. I'll have none of that behaviour. Thank you very much. And you are in with a chance of winning... Oh, I do beg your pardon. You are in with a chance of winning tickets for, I think it's two tickets for Soulfest. You know, the festival that's going on in Tudor Grange Park. And I've got to say, there are some terrific artists in on. There's Busted, I'm just looking. Sister Sledge, there's Roland Gift from the Fine Young Cannibals. There is the Lightning Seeds. There is Blue. There is quite a lot of Razor Lighter on. There's quite a few acts that are worth going to see. So if you'd like a chance to win these tickets, you need to go onto our Facebook page and you need to write a comment or your name, and your we will be drawing it on Matt's show on Thursday just after 6, I think Jeff said. I think it was just after 6. So if you're interested or you would like to win tickets, please have a go. You've got to be in it to win it. That's the thing, isn't it? You can't just sit there and go, well, I never won that. No, you didn't win it because you never had a go, that's why. Right, what's happening bank holiday weekend in Solihull? Let me have a look in my little itinerary. Let's have a look. Right, now I know on the Friday there is the open air cinema, and what they're playing is The Greatest Showman. Now the gates actually open at 6:15 and the film starts at 7, I think it's 7 or 7:30. Either way, I'd get there so you can get a nice position on the lawn, and let's hope it doesn't rain. What are they going to do if it rains? Not sure what's going to happen if it rains. But either way, please, if you'd like to go along to that, you need to go online and book your tickets, or let them, you book those tickets online. On Saturday and Sunday, the 25th and the 26th, it's Soulfest. So you need... if you want to go to that and you forgot, oh, I haven't bought my tickets, you need to get into our competition and hopefully win tickets. I think there are a few tickets left. You can get them online, or you go into Touchwood, and as you go in, there is an art gallery on the corner and a Starbucks on the other corner. If you go in that entrance, about two windows down, or maybe one window down, you'll see a shop, and it's got all the Soulfest stickers on the window. And you go in and say, could I have two tickets, or however many tickets you want? And they'll either say to you, well, we haven't got that many left, or yes, certainly, you can. That's how to do it. That's what you need to do. Right, is there anything else that I need to tell you about? Well, there is a few things I need to tell you about. Right, the big thing, now we are in big school. We have a uniform. Well, we don't actually have a uniform. They're rather nice. We have blue T-shirts. Polo shirts, I do believe that they are called in the fashion industry. And they're blue. And on the front, on the left-hand side, we have our logo with Solihull. I'm just looking at my logo to make sure. With Solihull Radio and our logo above it on our left side of our chest. And on our back, we have how you can listen to us. And you can listen to us on www.solihullradio.com. But if you see one of us, because we're the only ones that have got these T-shirts, there's no civilians with this uniform, I tell you. We're the only ones that have got this T-shirt. And we have hoodies as well. Well, some of us have. Some of us didn't bother with a hoodie, but I've got a hoodie and a T-shirt. And come up and say hello. Go, can you play this for me? Or, you know, whatever. You know, just walk up to us. It's a nice blue. And I actually today noticed that a few people were looking at it to see what it said. Yes, we do exist. I've had a few people say, oh, I didn't even know it. Sally, I'll add a radio. Yes, we do. And we're here for you. And you can actually see us in our T-shirts, because every time we're going to be doing something, we're actually going to be wearing them. You know, we're not going to live in them. You know, if I'm sitting at home watching Pole Dark, I'm not going to be sitting in my Solihull Radio T-shirt. But it's nice because it makes us feel like there we are. We're here now for your delight and delectation. Oopsie-daisy. I don't know what I did then. Right, I'm going to play you a bit of... I've just done Sam Smith. I can't be doing that again. I don't want to play any more Aretha Franklin because my last track out is Aretha Franklin and I want to play that for her. I'm going to play a bit of James Arthur. I think... I don't know who's been here. Who was here before me? I'm going to play it anyway. Let's go for it. No, I'm not.
Just not sure my heart is working. And yours is beating double time. Deep down you know I ain't even worth it. It's not enough, babe. All I do is make you cry. Like, ooh, oh, ooh, oh, I know I do this every time. Like, ooh, to say what's on my mind. You deserve better, better, better than me. Might be what you want, but I'm not what you need. You're better, better than you even realize. You deserve better, better, better than me. Might be what you want, but I want you to see. You're better off without me in your life. And I hope you find somebody else. Me, 'cause babe, I'm hopeless. The more it hurts, the more you try. You know I loved, I just never showed you. It'll be too late when you're with some other guy. Like, ooh, ooh, I know I do this every time. Like, ooh, say what's on my mind. You deserve better, better, better than me. Might be what you want, but I'm not what you need. You're better, better than you even realize. You deserve better, better, better than me. Might be what you want, but I want you to see. You're better off without me in your life. And I hope you find somebody. What you want, but not what you need, baby. Oh, yeah. You deserve better, better, better than me. Might be what you want, but I'm not what you need. You're better, better than you even realize. You deserve better, better, better than me. Might be what you want, but I want you to see. You're better off without me in your life.
I love you still.
fed up with condensation every morning and hate that yucky mold. It's time to contact EnviroVent. They've helped tackle mold and condensation dampness in over a million homes, just like yours. To find out more and to book a free home survey, visit EnviroVent.com, because air matters.
Solihullradio.com.
Stagecoach Solihull teaches skills
in drama, singing and dance.
But these skills don't just vanish when the curtain falls.
They're skills for life, stretching imaginations and improving literacy. For a career in the arts, learning new skills, or just having fun.
So visit our website,
www.stagecoach.co.uk/Solihull.
Stagecoach Solihull, skills for the arts.
Skills for life.
Yeah!
The Fireplace and Stove Centre, 1204 Stratford Road, Hall Green. Specialists in wood-burning stoves, gas and electric fires, with over 50 live displays in the showroom. Come in and experience your new fireplace solutions. Call 0121 777 8585 for more details.
You're listening to Solihull Radio.
Indian Dream on Dovehouse Parade, Solihull's premier family-run restaurant offering authentic Indian and Bangladeshi cuisine. With fresh ingredients and creative chefs, they can provide bespoke dining experiences, eat in or take away. 0121 704 9058.
Right, here we go. Oh, this is all very exciting. I've had an email. I don't normally get emails. Don't know what's going on. Right, I have been asked to play a request for. Now I'm gonna see what I can do, because I'm not actually au fait with this system yet. But I'm gonna do my best. Madonna, how old was she this week? She was 60, wasn't she? And somebody's asked for this track, and I'm really hoping that I can get it up. Oh, don't get me excited now, because you know, I'm thinking I can. Right, I'm going to play this now, and I'm hoping that it will work. And it is Madonna. Now, I've got to say, I don't know, I've always thought she's a little bit, what's it, Madonna? A little bit hard looking, do you know what I mean? She's got that sort of hardness about her face, but she's good. And I was clearing out my CDs this week, and I didn't save any for the station because some of them were a bit past it. I've given to my friend to swing round on her trees for the birds, because it frightens them off. Is it the birds or the squirrels? Oh, anyway, something gets frightened off by them. Anyway, I found Madonna, and I meant to bring it into play, but I will play this one instead. Here we go then, Tony. I'm hoping that this actually will play now.
Making the most of trying hard to control my heart. I walk over to where you are. Eye to eye, we need no words at all. Slowly now, we begin to move. Every breath I'm deeper in.
You go, Tony. I did my best. I've got look at me working the buttons. I'm getting better and better. Now I'm not going to worry next week. I did come in. Don't you think the first time is always the worst because you panic? Well, I do. Now, the only person who actually understands that for me is Jeff. Jeff does understand me slightly. Well. He looks at me in a bit of a moment. He looks at me sometimes so much as I say, what on earth is going on? I'm going to play this for you because I haven't done one of these for a while and I might need to get myself going.
Solihull Radio.
Just in case you forgot who we were, I thought I'd better play that, otherwise I can get into trouble. And he knows that Yes, I do. I struggle with change. I'm not very good on the change front. But now I've done it, I'll be all right. Now I've done it, I'm going to be okay. I don't know what's going on here. Now I'm going to be absolutely fine. And next week I'll be a lot more relaxed. I'll know what I'm doing. And because I got myself in a bit of state, because what you have to do to get in here is you have to come in the building, you have to speak to, and you have to do this, and you have to do that, and you have to do that. And then I had this dream last night that I drove up the wrong road. Then I had another dream. I fell asleep eventually at 3:10 this morning, and I had a dream that I actually went up the wrong corridor thing that's at the back here. And then I was like, so by the time I got up this morning, my stomach was flipping over and I hadn't got anybody to talk to about it because Jess is away on holiday and she's having the most wonderful time. Oh, Jeff's away and he's in Wales, and he texted me earlier to ask me something, and I said to him, have a nice walk, because he's gone for a walking holiday, which is a lovely idea. I love walking. And he said, it's absolutely thrown it down in Wales. I said, well, it's not much brighter here, really. They said we were going to have a nice day. I think we possibly need to say goodbye to the sunny weather. And I don't like saying goodbye to the... You know what's going to happen? We'll go back to work and all this... Anyway, I've had a look at the emails. I've seen Tony's, which I've just dealt with. And we have... Do you remember in the summer when we did a camber? Well, on the 25th of August, which is next Saturday, yes it is, they are actually doing a reggae magic night. Reggae? Is it reggae? Reggae? Oh, I don't know. Anyway, it's a night full of reggae classics. I'm going to cough, I do apologise. I got a little bit of a kink in my throat as I said that then. An art full of reggae classics, and you're going to get a two-course Caribbean complimentary meal. Or if it's anything like the chicken they did at Acamba when we went for the Sunfest. You're in for a treat. There's going to be a live band, a rum bar on there. A rum, I love rum, and a cocktail bar. And all for the glorious cost of £28. And it's on 6 till 11, so it's a good, you know, good for you. And you can book on 0121 733 311. So that's 0121 733 3111. And I've got to say that when we went with the radio show to Acamba in the summer, people there, oh, my God, it's such a lovely atmosphere. It really is a lovely atmosphere. Everybody's friendly. Everybody's happy. Okay, there was a little bit of, shall we say, libation involved. But nobody, they all just sat there and just were laughing and singing along to the music. It was absolutely fantastic. Right, what time is it now? Oh, it's 7:30 already. Where has the time gone? I'm going to, oh, let me just check that I haven't missed any emails, because I don't want somebody to be, no, I've done that one and I've done that one. Right, okay, we're fine. I'm going to play you two back-to-back of my favourite singles. I was going to do a bit of Latin tonight, but what I need to do is work out, now I've got this playlist thing going on, I'm all right, but I need to just work out the techie stuff here. So I'm going to play you tonight two of my favourite singers. I'm going to play Jess Glynn, and then we're going to go straight into, which one was it? Paloma Faith. So I'm going to play you I'll Be There, which is Jess Glynn's new track, and I'm going to play you Paloma Faith's new track, which is called Warrior. So here we go, folks. Enjoy two of the greatest, well, I love them. I like these two. I do.
When all the tears are rolling down your face, and it feels like yours was the only heart to break. When you come back home and all the lights are out, and you're getting used to no one else being around. For you. Oh.
break down, tears fall to the ground. Tell myself they were nothing, can't be found. And you're a fighter, you're a fighter, you're a fighter, fight on, baby. Some days I'm sure I lose to fate. Some days I cannot find my faith, but I just fight on, I just fight on, I just fight on, baby, baby. And I am a wounded warrior, now that the enemy's closing in. I am a wounded warrior, looking for someone to let me in. I'm begging you, take me in. I'm surrendering, black and blue. But if I'm with you, if I'm with you, I'll live to fight on through. I let go, walk into the unknown. If I surrender, if I lay my arms down, am I a fighter? Am I a fighter? 'Cause I've been fighting so long, baby.
Go, aren't they? I just love them two songs. I really do. I like the fact that, oh, you know what I'm like. I'm into my empowerment and positive thinking, and I like strong women, and they're two very strong women. I feel like if I went out for a drink with them, that we'd get on very well. Anyway, getting back to Madonna, she's 60. And I've got to say, she's looking good. But don't you think? I've been looking at actually a few women, like Emma Thompson was on Chris Evans yesterday morning, and there's one. Don't you think women are looking better now? They're in the 50s. See, when my mum hit her 40s, now, mum, I'm not being rude, but I love you to bits, but she suddenly developed this penchant for crimpling skirts and blouses with high necks and whatever. And I could never understand, because my mother always used to wear like trendy dresses, and she always looked, you know, beehive when I was growing up. The beehives were in fashion and stuff. And I just didn't know where all this had come from, and it was really weird. But I think now that women are so much more trendy, don't you? I mean, I'm 55 and I'm still wearing, like, I wear what I want. I wear my brogues with my miniskirt. I wear my black tights for work. You know, I wear more than my black tights. But, you know, I wear what I'm happy in. And I'm going to be the woman that when I leave this mortal coil and I'm lying in my box, that you need to bury with red lips, because it's just not happening. I'm not going to get... I refuse to get old. I refuse not to live life and enjoy it. And I think... Looking at Madonna, I mean, she looks fantastic. Emma Thompson looks phenomenal. I mean, if anything, they look better than they ever have. And I think it's, there's a lot more actually in the beauty market, isn't there, that we use. We are a very lucky generation, to be fair. We've got a lot of stuff that, you know, can cover up a lot of creases. That's all I'm saying. But when I had a really bad bout of psoriasis, the hospital told me to use shower oil, which I've been doing, and a cream that complements that shower oil. I don't think I should say names because it's advertising. But either way, but I have noticed such a difference in my skin. And I even now get this oil, and when I've washed my face, because I use a scrub every day, and then I use my soap. And when I've washed my face, I put the oil on and I leave it on while I'm doing whatever I'm doing, like washing my hair or whatever, so that it has time to... And I've got to say that my skin does feel so much better. So, God bless you, Madonna. You are 60 and you look absolutely blooming fantastic, girl, I've got to say. Emma Thompson looks fantastic. J-Lo... has got a six-pack. I'm gonna have to get to the gym. That's what I'm gonna do. That's my thing. I've gotta start working out again. I used to work out all the time, and I didn't look good, but I didn't look bad. You know what I mean? I'm not the most stunning of women facially, so I just have to make the most of what I've got, and I've got the biggest hair ever. But there you go. That's what life tells you. Anyway, let's have a look what's going on at the theatre, shall we? Right, at the... I know what I forgot. Bank Holiday Weekend. We have, the Open Air Cinema, which I mentioned. We have Soul Fest, which I've mentioned. But on Monday, on the Bank Holiday Monday, we have Chance to Dance. And it's a dance festival. I know for a fact that Diversity are on. So you can imagine there's going to be quite... of course, I'm not on there booing and shaking what my mother gave me. No, I'm not on there, but they missed a trick there, not asking me on. I could show somebody how to dance to reggae, I'll tell you. Anyway, what's happening at the theatre? The Core Theatre, I've told you about the Black Country Night, which is good to go to, if you can understand what they say. There's another band. No, they're not a band. There's... two gentlemen, what was it, two or three? But they're called Cosmo Theatre. Cosmo Theatre. I hope I've said that right. I apologise if I haven't. And they're on the Wednesday, the 24th of October. And it's a musical. It's a musical show. So if you're into your musical, then that's worth going along to. Don't forget about our competition on Facebook. You've just got to literally go on our Facebook page and write your name or... who you'd like to win the tickets for. Also at the Core Theatre, we have Bhangra and Bollywood Dance Workshop on Thursday the 23rd of August. That's next Thursday. And it's for children aged 6 to 14 years. You do need to get tickets. But I do recommend that you learn, you know, because my friend Seetal, she's a big Bhangra star and she dances beautifully. It's nice, something nice to do. Then we have Morgan and West Children's Magic Show. That's on the 30th of August, so you'll need to book tickets for that. I went in, actually, to the Core today to ask about this hula hooping and roller skating lark. And the two ladies behind the desk were very nice, so thank you very much. And on Friday, the 2nd of November, always one for little Molly O'Brien. She might like this. Julia Donaldson's Tabby McTat. Now, I love that story. It's not one of her most well-read ones, but I do love it. Tabby McTat, and it's on Friday the 22nd of November, and it's a half-term week, and it's a Julia Donaldson story, so you can't go wrong, can you, really? Music-wise at the Core, We have 5th and the 6th of September, the ELO Experience. And as I said before, I do know somebody who's been to that. And they said it's absolutely fantastic. And on the 7th to the 8th of September, we have the Roy Orbison Story. Now, that would be nice to go to because I quite like his music. And we have, brace yourselves, hold them arms on that chair, the Barnhart and Huxley Jazz Night. And it's on Wednesday the 19th of September. And it's jazz and jokes. Jazz and jokes. Don't quite know what that would be, but there you go. Then I'm going to tell you about Hall Green Little Theatre, what's on there, because that is my second home. I've told you about my new ideas for my show. So please, if you have any other ideas, I'd like to do like a problem. It won't be a problem page. What would it be? A problem section. Should we say section? Yes. Moment. Problem moment. I like that. Problem moment. Well, I'd like to do that. If you've got something that's really bothering you that you need to get off your chest. I'm not an expert, but if I can help you, I will help you. I'd like to think I might be of some assistance in this mad world that we live in. And the other idea is that I either get somebody, a religious leader from each religion, that, because we are very eclectic in this country. Whether you live in Solihull, Birmingham, North Solihull, wherever you live, there is a variety of races and religions. And I would love one of you. So really, it would just take, if I had, say, five of you, it would just be one thing a week, wouldn't it? Now, I do. If I can do this show every Saturday and everybody else on this station can do their show every week, we're asking you to do it once a month. So if you know of anybody who would actually be good and giving us a positive thought based on, I don't know, a Bible reading, a scripture, whatever, please get in touch. Otherwise, I am going to grab hold of the great British public that is in Solihull and surrounding areas and ask for them, for their pause for thoughts, for their positive affirmations. And because, you know, I have my ideas, but I'd like to hear yours. I'd like to know who's out there listening to me. I'd like to know what you're doing right now. Well, within reason, I would. So maybe I could bring that in. What are you doing right now? Are you sitting there about to tuck into a vindaloo? I don't know, do I? I'm not Psychic Bill from Psychicville, but there you go. Anyway, I am going to play a bit of Paolo Nutini. I'm going to come back, tell you about Hall Green Little Theatre, what is happening on Solihull Radio next week, and about my future guests. That is what I'm going to do. Right, let's try a bit of Paolo, because I do like Paolo. And he's very nice looking. He's a bit too young for me, but he's quite nice looking. Grant my last request.
Slow down, lie down. Remember, it's just you and me. Don't sell out, bow out. Remember how this used to be. I just want you closer. Is that alright? Baby, let's get closer tonight. Grant my last request and just let me hold you. Don't shrug your shoulders. Lay down beside me. Sure, I can accept that we are going nowhere, but one last time, let's go there. Lay down beside me. I realize all about your lies, but I'm no wiser than the fool that I
want you closer. Is that all right? Baby, let's get closer tonight. Grant my last request and just let me hold you. Don't shrug your shoulders. Lay down beside me and show I can accept that we're going nowhere. But one last time, let's go there. Ooh, lay down beside me, oh. Tell me how can this be wrong? Grant my last request and just let me hold you. Don't shrug your shoulders. Lay down beside me. Sure, I can accept that we are going nowhere. But one last time, let's go there. Lay down beside me. Grant my last request and just let me hold you. Don't shrug your shoulders, no. Lay down beside me. And sure, I can accept that we are going nowhere. But one last time, let's go there. Lay down beside me. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, lay down beside me. Let's go, yeah. Lay down beside me.
Right, you can't, I'll tell you, you can't go wrong with Polo. He's absolutely fantastic. And he is as cool. Is he cool or what? I think he's absolutely fantastic. And I'm just now thinking, let me pause that, because at the moment I don't want that on. I want that on. And that on. That's what I want on. I'm going to play one more track and then I'm going to go. Right, what's going on at Hall Green Little Theatre? Now, I have a soft spot for Hall Green Little Theatre because it's where they taught me to act. They're fantastic people and I love every second and every inch of the bones of those people. And they are absolutely wonderful. When you're trying to get a play together, it's not the easiest things. And you know, when you're trying to direct a play and the person you're trying to direct doesn't do what you want them to do, it's so frustrating. And yeah, people get ratty with each other and it's whatever. But I've got to say that I absolutely love acting. I do. But I've made a decision to stand back from it for a bit and concentrate on my radio show. I'm quite glad I have at the moment because... Now, the radio, this place is getting bigger than we ever thought it would. And it's all thanks to you for listening in. And we're very grateful. So I am focusing on this at the moment because I can't do too much because I don't want to be poorly and I don't want to miss anything, you know, that I can give to you, which to me is important. I love doing this. I never thought in all my life. If somebody says to me, you know, have you thought about radio? And no. Why would I think about radio? I listen to it. I love my radio. In fact, I don't watch the telly. I listen to radio all the time. But if somebody has said to me 3 years ago, you were going to be doing this, I'd have gone, yeah, dream on. And I am, and I can't believe that I am doing it. I still can't get my head into the I am doing this as something that I love. I was talking to Lee yesterday and Lee said she loves doing it as well. It's very tiring. I mean, I'm wiped out on a Sunday. I'm absolutely wiped out, but I wouldn't change it. I wouldn't change anything I'm doing right now in my life. I really wouldn't, and I'm grateful for it. Anyway, Hall Green Little Theatre, A Box of Frogs. Now, they're like an improv comedy team. They're actually on at the Core as well. I think they must be going from the Core to Hall Green Little Theatre. They're on at 8th of September at 8 o'clock. there's the Vicar of Dibley, which is on the 14th to the 22nd of September. You need to go and see that because they do that brilliantly. We have Alice in Wonderland. My daughter is in this. It's the youth theatre and it's between 5 and the 5th and the 13th of October. And my daughter is playing one of the Tweedledums, I don't know which one it is, and the March Hare. And then we have a play called Heroes. And Heroes is a comedy about... Let me have a look. I've got the booklet here. About soldiers finding life in a retirement home unbearable. So that should be quite funny, actually. I'm going to actually play you one more track and then I'm going to tell you what's happening on... Am I going to have time? I might tell you what's happening on Solihull Radio next week, and because I don't want to cram it all in. And what my future guests... I'll do the future guests thing first. Right, my future guests. I've definitely booked Danny Stone to come on. And I'm absolutely, totally in love with this guy. And he's gay, but I love him. I fell in love with him the minute I saw him. I can't even say... Maybe I shouldn't say that, but I did, Danny. It's a shame you are gay, because I would have gone out with you, but there you go. Anyway, I then have... I'm going to book a firefighter to come on. I'm going to book a police dog handler to come on. I'm going to book Danny's friend Ricky to come on, who is a self-made businessman, and I think his story will be quite interesting. And I'm going to try and get on my friend Jean, her husband Jean, and Cito. They are quite big in the Bangra scene, and they have a band, so I will need some help that night. I was going to say, would you mind me doing it? I don't know where I thought I was then. I lost track of thought. I was just doing something. Right, next week, Solihull Radio, we've only got 3 minutes left. Can you believe it? We have, tomorrow, we have Lee. It's her first show in the new studio as well, with her cornucopia of sound and music. In the morning, we have our Alex. He's on 8 till 10. To entertain your little diddlies, and late in the afternoon between 4 and 6. Now, in the week, we are starting a new breakfast show between 7 and 9, and it's with our new presenter. Her name is Natalie. Hi, Natalie. Love to speak to you. And she's going to be doing a breakfast show every day, 7 till 9. So welcome aboard the good ship, Solihull Radio. I hope you enjoy our company. On the night, we have our lovely Duncan with his wingback chair and his tartan and his glass of whiskey and his cigar and his American songbook. And somebody said to me the other day, Duncan, that they really enjoy that and your voice suits your show very much. Tuesday, we have Nick. No, we don't. We have, sorry, Jeff. We have Jeff and his legal, medical, musical extravaganza. We have Wednesday, we have a necktie Nick who came in tonight and helped me. Thank you, Nick, with his lovely lady Kirsten. Thank you, Nick. Love you to bits. You're a great mate. Thank you so much. Thursday, we have Matt and his young and trendy young things. Lovely music. I listened this week. I really enjoyed it. Friday, we have... In the morning, we have John Harris and he's doing his topical show about Solihull and surrounding areas and music and anything else that he has gets his paws on. And the night we have Reevesy, who is my mate. He's another mate I love to bits. And hi, and he's with his bad sense of humour and his music and his quizzes and his connection thing. And Saturday we have Josh in the afternoon. I keep forgetting Josh. I'm so sorry. Josh between 3 and 5 talking sport, and more sport. And then I'm back on 6 till 8. I have loved your company. Thank you for joining me on my first go in the new studio. I hope you've enjoyed yourself. I'm going to leave you with Aretha. There's only no other way to leave you. And one of her greatest songs. And enjoy. Love you all. Take care and please look after yourselves. I have been me. Take care. Bye. Let's go for a bit of a reading.